Hi. In this time, we will use particles to create the effect of splashing water. First, import the texture, create a material to be used for the particle, and open the window. The source of the texture is Vehicle Game in the Learn tab of Epic Games. There are also various textures, so please refer to them. Next, set the blend mode to translucent and the shading model to unlit. Then, create a particle color node to use the color of the particle system and connect it to the emissive color. Now you can add a variety of colors if you want in the emitter. Next, hold down the keyboard T and click to create a texture sample. Then, set the previously imported texture. After that, if you create a multiply node by clicking it while holding down the keyboard M and connecting it like the video, you can see only the water part appears. Save and exit to the content browser. Next, create a particle and double-click it to open the window. Click required to set up the material you created. After that, since the emitter loop is set to 0 and repeats continuously, change it to 1 in order to only once. Next, click Spawn and set the rate to 1 so that it is created only once. And by adding a burnt list, it appears as much as the specified number when it is created once. Next, click Lifetime to set the duration of the particle. Next, click Initial Size to set the particle size. Now set the size range of max and min, and the size will appear randomly within the range of values. Next, click Initial Velocity to set the particle's velocity. Set the range to the left and right, and set the Z value higher to make the water splash upward. Next, create a constant acceleration and set the value in the opposite direction of water splashing to create a natural water splash. Next, we create an initial rotation to add random rotation of the particles. You can adjust the range if you want. When finished, save it and exit to the content browser. Next, let's make the particles appear on the feet. Go to Mannequin's Animation folder, find Third Person Run, and double-click to open the animation window. Now we're going to create an Animation Notify, which is an animation version that generates events in Blueprint. After pausing the animation being played, specify the time zone where the feet touch the floor and create a notification by right-clicking. Generate both feet's notify as this way. The point you set becomes the moment the particles appear. When you have finished setting the notification name and point, save it and exit to the content browser. Next, double-click on the animation blueprint next to it and open the window. Create event anim notify nodes by searching for the previously created notify name. Once the notify event has been created, create a spawn emitter at location and connect it. This node is created at the specified location. Next, let's reference the player with getPlayerPawn. Then, create a getActorLocation node and connect it to the referenced player location. Next, add the position by setting a value using the Vector plus Vector node to match the floor and foot position. When you are done, connect to the spawn emitter node to location in order to receive the location value. Copy the nodes we did so far and adjust and connect the values to the other side as in the video. Finally, set the water splash particle we already made in the template of the spawn emitter node, save it, and then go to the content browser. Now when you play, you can see particles appear from the feet while the character is running.